You know, so odd that you said it. My mentor, Customato, his objective was to think of nothing. You're nothing. Nothing's nothing but the objective, the job. Mm-hmm. And that was his psychological warfare. You know, nothing matters. You're nothing, nothing. The only thing that matters is the objective and getting through, accomplishing that objective by going through these methods of boxing.
Do you ever stop and think about how fortunate it was you ran into that guy?
Listen, to this day, I really don't understand that. So how did this happen?
Because so many people.
Listen, by the time I was born, he was 66 years old by the time I was born.
Yeah, crazy. So many people could, you know.
Can't even explain it. It's a magnificent individual.
He was an amazing guy, an amazing part of boxing, and with an unprecedented grasp of the mindset required for combat sports. That was the thing that always really stood out about him. Like, he was a guy that was so well versed in the mindset. I would listen to his speeches that he would talk when he would talk about you, and he would talk about boxing. He would talk about fear. And about fear can be like a fire, can cook your food, or it can burn your house down. Mm-hmm. And you have to control it. And when he would describe it, like, it would be so enlightening. He was such a man of wisdom that when he would describe things, they would sink in. They would somebody could say the same thing, but with him, he had so much life experience.
He wore so many hats. He was a psychiatrist. Yeah. He was a doctor. He was a father. He was a mother. You know, he was just all around that individual.
Yeah, and with an amazing knowledge of boxing. And for a guy like you, it was almost like it was ordained.
And that's what I always said. It was meant for me to meet this guy. Because I had no way in a million years. Everybody would say, no way you're going to be champ. You're too small.
Yeah.
So you're too short. No way. These guys are too big for you. He always said, this is the greatest fight I ever lived. This and this, always saying this about me. I'm like, oh, God, this guy's just souping me up. I never thought I could, you know, achieve what he was saying. The things he was saying was just so gigantic in my eyes at the time.
Yeah, I mean, when it all happened, and it turned out that he was true, and you have to absorb all this when you're 20 years old. You know, I always say this about Justin Bieber, and I don't think Justin Bieber nearly had to deal with what you had to deal with. Your experience was so much crazier because you were not just an incredibly famous guy. You were the baddest man on the planet. So there was like an aura to you everywhere you went. People wanted to see you. You know, 50-year-old men don't give a fuck about Justin Bieber. You know, no disrespect. He's a great guy, a great singer. But it's not – he's like young girls. For young girls, that guy's unbelievably famous. But he's been famous since he was a little kid. I'm like, when people hear about
him
going crazy.
That's amazing, right?
Amazing. When people hear about him going insane, I'm like, of course he's going insane. You have no idea what it would be like to be him and to be 17 years old and girls literally trying to break into his house to throw pussy at him. They're coming down chimneys. They're flying in on parachutes. They're doing anything they can. They just want to be around him. And you want him to be
Justin.
Normal?
Oh, man, poor guy.